Thanks, everyone. I've never spoken for under 6 minutes, so this should be a great challenge. This is what you see when you walk into 42 North. It's not our address, it's the latitude and longitude of where the building is, and we all here live within the 42nd parallel. And we love this because the 42nd parallel is known for its hop growing. It also divides states like New York and Pennsylvania. It also divides countries throughout the world. So the 42nd parallel is very, very significant. And this hasn't moved yet, so I'm going to press one button and see if it goes. This is the building here, 12,000 square feet. This is the building 7 months ago, I should say. It's been an aquarium. It's been an archery range. It's been a warehouse. It's been an office. It's been an auto mechanic shop. But we think it's found its true meaning, beer. Everything within 42 North is built on these three principles: quality, authenticity, and collaboration. From the designers, architects that we've used, I'm going to tell you about the materials in the building, which also reside from the 42nd parallel, but everything we do, from brewing the beer, to the environment we created, to quite frankly, the people we hire, quality, authenticity, collaboration. These are our guiding principles. And by the way, that's a local artist, Tom Bojanowski, who walked in one night and just started chalking. It was great. We had a deadline. This equipment was being delivered on June 22nd of this past summer. So there was not a lot of latitude for skipping deadlines. So we really had a deadline. This is a photograph of our equipment being delivered. This is coming down Main Street, East Aurora. So we had a deadline because there was nowhere else to put this other than in the building. This is a image of the warehouse in February. As I mentioned, this building served as a warehouse actually for one of my former companies. So it wasn't very attractive. If you see the great images and the great insulation and lighting, and here's what it begins to look like in 2 months later. So we put in all the tile floors. We had to put in all of the drainage, the concrete pads where all of our beer equipment sits. And hopefully you'll see what this now looks like today. There it is today. A little bit of a transformation. Very proud of our brew house. What's interesting or great about this is we've also invested in the infrastructure. If you see a lot of the piping above and the concrete pads below, we are prepared to double our capacity on a moment's notice. The Richardson Complex, it's interesting we're doing this here in the presentation. We were able to salvage the bricks and a lot of the wood from the landfill, and we actually had it dropped off in the front door of the brewery because we wanted to use as many local materials as possible. We faced 5,000 bricks. As a matter of fact, Fred, who's back there serving the beer for 42 North, I think did 1,242 of them. But as we'll go into looking at the interior, these bricks, when the bricks showed up, we didn't know what to do with them. But what we decided to do was build the columns. And the columns, as you'll see, surround the tap room. We cut them to 5/8 inch, and again, I think we cut, last we counted, was 5,000 of these bricks. As the tap room started to develop, this we're probably looking here at late summer, a 44-foot bar. Bar and serving beer, those kind of go together. So we decided, you know, let's build what at least we know is the largest bar in East Aurora. So we've got that going for us. We've got that going for us. And what we did here is we used a concrete brick top from a local, I think 716 Concrete was who built the bar for us. And what's great about that black concrete is it really looks great when you have a beer on top of it. It really pulls the color of that beer. And here's another photograph just to show you how it starts to look. We also put those bricks on the facade of the bar. And the other wood you see there is from a barn that came down in Holland, New York in November. So we went for that. And now you start to see how this starts to look today. I don't know how many of you have been in to 42 North, but it's a great, great, approachable, comfortable, very rustic environment, which we believe complements the feel of East Aurora. Another view of the bar. Can't have enough photographs of the bar. Even the tap handles, if you look at those big tap handles, those are also were made from the Richardson wood that we reclaimed. And as you know, Edison lighting is very in vogue right now at breweries. So here's the before. And next you'll see the after. This was used for meeting space for our company and a few companies, but we really think that as this starts to dissolve here, we've created a much better environment for meeting.
Yeah,
it's a great spot. If you look to here, you actually see the beer. If you look in those windows in the back, you can actually look into the brewery. So you're actually watching the professionals, the artists back there creating the beer while you're enjoying, you know, kind of the fruits of their labor. I really think that's key with a lot of the craft breweries. You want to be able to kind of see what you're eating, see what you're drinking. Here's the before. This is what the building looked like a year and a half ago. Again, it was a furniture store. It's been an aquarium, archery, and we decided to update the front of the look. That's not quite as appealing and as inviting as we'd like. So that's what the building looks like today. A little bit of a conversion. We like using that corrugated metal. Again, that complements what's in this with the stainless steel, and then with the wood base. And the last photograph here is really kind of, I would call it, the fruits of our labor and a full tap room. So whatever we did, the reason we did it was to create an environment like this. So if you haven't been down to 42 North, I'd encourage you to raise a pint and come out and join us. Thank you.